I am Ricardo Navarro. I am from El Salvador. I am a member of the Global Alliance for Incineration Alternatives. In high school, we learned that matter cannot be created or destroyed. It can only be transformed. When you incinerate something, you get three kinds of ashes. First, all the ash that comes to the ground. Then the fly ash, and then nanoparticles. All these are very toxic. The best incinerators, the best ones, what they do is they collect some of the fly ash, which is the toxic ash, and that goes to a landfill. And that pollutes the soil, pollutes the water. And there is another thing. In the ashes, some of them are nanoparticles. Nano is very, 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 very small. Nanoparticles, there is no way you can put a filter, because the holes in the filter, the diameter of the holes, are bigger than the nanoparticles. Not even the hematoencephalic barrier in your brain can stop them. So that nanoparticles, they go through your brain because they're extremely small, you know, at the atom size level. And that is impossible to stop. Now they call it pyrolysis, they call it plasma arc, you know, a lot of gasification they use, and the Danish enterprises like Rambo are expert at deceiving the people using all these fancy names. We managed to stop in El Salvador at least twice incinerators. Another time they offer us all the ashes, because you see, in incinerations, 30% is ash, toxic ashes, and eventually they don't know what to do with them. So they offer us the ashes, and they were going to build 400 houses with them. And of course, we talked to the population, and we told them how that was going to be very toxic. Another thing that they are still doing in El Salvador, and we are fighting, is that the cement manufacturers, Holcim, you know, they burn the things, and all the toxic ashes they put into the cement. And of course, when you go to your house, you have all the toxics in your house. And those companies say, we don't generate waste. Well, they don't generate waste because all the toxics they put in the cement, and then they sell the cement, and then that's what we buy. In the roads, for example, when you go with your car, sometimes the roads, when they put cement, they are this thick, and 20 years later, they are this thick. So that means all those toxics end up in the air, and then we breathe them. So incineration is certainly the worst way of treating all the municipal wastes.